I'm attorney Pat Dunn. Auto accidents are a part of life. I hope you never need an attorney, but if you do, the team at the Mack Law Firm is here to help.
Well, Vice President of the Board Tom Tolar joins us now, and the vice presidency part is not the main thing. He's the North End board member, one of a couple of those, but boy, what a storm system we had through Kentwood.
Yeah, we did. Last Friday afternoon, we had a little tornado that came through Kentwood, made us a small path right through town, did a lot of damage with trees, power lines, some buildings and roofs, and then went across like the Lion Creek area, Highway 1053, and then went out that way. So I'm very fortunate, no loss of life. I don't think we had any damage at Kentwood High School other than a few things just kind of blown around a little bit, but it was very fortunate that it bounced up and over most of Kentwood.
You know, you're still dealing with the damage from Ida. For instance, right. Tonight, the roof at Punchatoula High School.
Right. Yeah, we're still dealing with that. We still have canopies that we still need to replace. The roof at Punchatoula High School has been something that we've been working on for over a year. The roof has been finished, but just not completely finished, and there's some things that's still leaking and it's causing more damage, so we're trying to figure out exactly how to go about fixing that as well.
One story that I don't think has been told is that the bounce back we did from Ida, it happened so quickly. Kudos to us, but you don't recover from that kind of a storm overnight.
No, you don't, and we have a lot of facilities. You know, before Ida, we had a lot of facility needs. Ida just forced our hand on a lot of roofs and a lot of things that we needed to fix, but the facility needs still continue. We still need room. We still need classroom space. Our phase two projects have been kind of slowed down, for lack of a better word, because of federal funding and things we have to do to make sure that we're covering the basis to make sure that federal funds pay for some of these projects. But yeah, we really need to speed up our phase two projects because we need classroom space to put children in.
Well, in the meantime, on the board agenda, three parents or groups of parents are questioning the discipline handed out to their children who are students. And it's getting back once again to the perennial problem of fighting. Now, looking at even the court system, there is not a decline in fighting in school. Now, that tells me two things. One, it's still a perennial problem. But secondly, if there are that many arrests, you guys are not being overly lenient.
No, we're not being overly lenient. And look, we understand there's a lot of reasons why kids will act out, either turn to violence, fight. There's pressures on social media. There's pressures just in being a teenager in general. There's the safety of knowing that at school, if I start a fight, somebody will separate us. There's a lot of things that go into school violence. But we have to continue to try to find creative ways to solve this. And, you know, alternative school, unfortunately, is our best option at the moment, to where if someone gives up their chance to go to a traditional school, we can at least continue their education at an alternative school. But, you know, more resource officers, we're looking at hiring different security type things at our schools, more officers, maybe not sheriff's deputies, maybe private security, to protect our employees and to protect our students. But we said this before, and I will continue to say it, cell phones are probably the biggest distraction we have in schools. A lot of these fights that I have seen that people have recorded, they have started recording prior to the fight starting. That tells me that it was staged, that it was waiting to happen. So when those kind of things happen like that, we have to punish those that are filming, the ones that are spreading that film, and the ones that are fighting.
Well, is that going to happen? Is the board?
Absolutely. We already have a policy against the filming of that. I don't know how often we've been able to actually actually hold someone accountable for that, simply because a video starts getting spread and it goes viral and everybody sees the video, but proving who made the video sometimes gets to be pretty difficult unless we have them on our school video. But that is something that we have to do. We're talking about new creative ways. We went to a school board conference 2 weeks ago, and one of the things we talked about there was like the red zone and green zones. Having a green zone, which is clearly identified as this is a safe place to use phones. Everything outside of that green zone is a red zone, whether it be the classrooms, library, gym, whatever. We want kids to be able to use technology. We want them to be able to have their phones, but we have to learn, we have to teach them how to balance that technology with education.
Well, there's even a bill in the state legislature this year from Senator Beth Mizell that would ban cell phones outright in school.
There is, and we talked to Senator Mizell about that. The bill right now, as proposed, would be just the classroom, not the hallways, not the common areas. which is kind of what we're thinking now with the green and the red zone. So it's, there's a lot of similarities there.
And would you say if that doesn't work, you could get tougher on cell phones?
Yes, we're going to have to. We're going to have to. That's not the end and cure all for the violence. You know, we need parental help. We need community help. I'm a big advocate of, you really want to change behavior of a child, you have to inconvenience the parents. If the parents have to come to a class with their child on a Saturday to sit through some type of remediation class or anger management class, if the parent has to get involved to get that kid back in good standing, maybe then we'll start getting some help from parents in the community about stopping this.
Well, in the meantime, good news here at the school board. Tonight, you're going to honor the Students of the Year.
Absolutely.
And, you know, it's amazing to me when you actually get together. And Virgil Allen, the ex-superintendent from a bygone era, he used to say, you know, there might be a parish with higher test scores in the aggregate than us, but you take our top 20%, I'll stack them against Harvard. I mean, our 20% tops, they're the best. No one can beat us. Yeah. There's truth in that.
Absolutely. What's really sad, though, is probably 90% of our efforts revolve around the 10% that are causing problems. And then you see tonight, you'll see with the students that we recognize, you know, these are the brightest and the best. We need to make sure that we're putting the focus on them as well, and not all of our focus on discipline, all of our focus on all the trouble that we have in schools. Because I know, like at Roseland, my daughter was one of the runner-up for Student of the Year, and she put a lot of work into her presentation, put a lot of work into everything she did. I am tickled to death for these students because they represent families that are working together for our school system. If you go to every one of these Student of the Years and look at them, they're backed by a family that's supporting them in our school system. The more support we can get at home, the better our students will be in all of our schools.
What else are you working on?
That's it. Just a lot of different things going on with the school system, and, you know, just asking people to continue as we get prepared for testing, making sure that that kids continue to come to school, keep truancy down, so that our teachers have a chance to work with and prepare them for their tests that are coming up.
Injuries can occur anytime, anyplace, and it may not be your fault. I'm Attorney Sherman Matt, and it's my duty to make sure you get the legal representation that you deserve. At the Mack Law Firm, we represent you and your family, and we'll make sure your legal needs are met. Contact us at tangylawteam.com. Our team is ready to help.